okay, same, same like before. Enjoying life. Free.
Well, that's cool. Yeah. Free. I love free.
Freedom.
Yeah. Freedom's awesome. Yeah. Well, first off, wow, you're back. Woo! I thought you were gone.
No, I'm still here. Come on. I told you it's not a goodbye. Hi.
Never a goodbye. Never. So you're working for Third Wave now.
Yay.
Yeah. Can you tell us how you got started with that?
How I got started? Actually, when I was in UKIS, like back then, for like 1 year ago, I actually met Pastor Johnny.
Oh.
Yeah, and he was really nice, and he like talked about his visions and Third Wave and everything. But unfortunately, you know, being in an idol group, I was like busy going around Asia and doing this and that, preparing new album and blah blah blah. And so finally now I'm free. So I finally decided to. Yeah, go for Third Wave since I'm free. So I'm here. Yeah. Are you guys happy?
Yes.
I am.
Woo. Yeah. So let's see here. So you're going to tentatively sing three songs on the new album, with one of the songs being Looking for the Day.
Oh right? Yeah.
How do you feel about singing the same song that Super Junior Siwon and Fly to the Sky Brian have previously sang?
Oh God, have mercy on me. No, I would say, I mean, it's always an honor to like sing a song which everybody, like other sonbaeni, we got a senior sang. I would say that, of course, my music level, you know, my skills is not as good as them, but I would just say that I'm gonna try my best and just sing it with my heart. Just praise God, and I'm just gonna make it the Sandernese style. I mean, yeah, just try to make it my style and everything. So just look forward. Hope you guys like it.
I'm sure we will.
Oh, don't cover your ears. I'm looking for the day. I'm actually nervous, you know, I don't know why, but...
Why?
I feel naked. You know, it's like, it's like, because usually when you're in a group, an idol group, you're in a group, so everybody covers each other up. Mm-hmm. You know, like, you don't have to sing the whole song and everything, so it's kind of a challenging thing for me, but, I mean, no stress, I mean, it's, come on, I'm doing this to enjoy it, and to praise God, so... Yeah, I guess you guys will be like excited to listen to my voice, and just, I hope I don't freak you guys out.
And is this your first time working with Johnny?
Johnny, like in what way? Like
musically.
Yeah, way. And music. Yeah, because previously, actually, I have joined his Bible study a couple of times and met him up for lunch and dinner and all these things. But music, yeah, it's my first time, and I'm glad because. It's not only that I have to do it by myself, but he would teach me a lot of things, and it's the whole thing, the whole process is like so funny. I'm excited, you know, even before starting it. Kirei juseyo, expect a lot of things. I can see you looking back at me. It's so awesome just to know. I would say that. I won't say it's a changing of line because, you know, before I actually even started UKIS, I would say that I was already working in this way. Like, I was in the church doing this praise and worship thing. So it was just a transition turning into an idol group, actually, you know, trying to be cute and. Oh my gosh! But I'm glad to know I'm free of obligation. I would just say that I have more time to do what I really want to do, and I'll be still doing like I'll try to be an idol star, still a K-pop idol star, but I just don't know when. For the time being, I just want to focus on doing praise and worship, praise God, spread the God's words of God and everything. And it's fun, actually. I know everybody say it's like so funny that from a K-pop to like worshiping thing, but I'd say it's actually similar, same fun thing. I love it! Yeah!
Right. So, some random Alexander facts.
Yeah.
I heard that you could speak 7 languages!
Yay!
Which 7?
I was born in Hong Kong, I grew up in Macau, so I could speak Cantonese, Mandarin, and I learned English, and because in Macau, it's Portuguese, and my mom's Korean, and I came here to learn Korean, and I was interested in Japanese, and I went to study in the States, so I learned a little Spanish, a little bit of everything, but now I'm like, my brain memory is like, oh, fading! But I heard that you know how to speak Cantonese, right?
Yeah, I know how to speak Cantonese.
Is it Gangneung-wa?
Oh,
is it Gangneung-wa? Oh, that's, I mean, I was grew up in this way, so I learned a lot of different languages.
So can you say something to our viewers?
What kind you guys want? I love you? Okay, the cheesy one!
Yeah, the cheesy one!
I love you, 아니고, 내 te amo, te amo, 아시테루, 사랑해요, you!
Woo!
Oh, gosh, goosebumps. I'm sorry.
So, with so many languages under your belt, have you ever thought about going into the entertainment industry in other places other than Korea, like Hong Kong, China, or the US? Or are you really like some kind of secret agent?
Oh no, I'm not a secret agent. I would say yes. I would love to go around this. Like I say, Hallyu, your K-pop stuff and everything, it's not only about being in Korea, but it's about being international. And I would say that it's like inside my blood, you know, come on, I'm already pretty much in like multicultural background and everything. So I would love to expand to China, Chinese market, and any English-spoken country, or maybe even Spain, Portugal, because I know that there are like fans all around the world. So yeah, I have a big dream, so I'll try.
All right.
Yeah. Oh yeah, actually, when I first came to Korea, I couldn't speak Korean well because my mom didn't really taught me, so it's so difficult, you know. Even if I have to go to any place, I have to tell a taxi driver, I have to even call my aunt, and she can help me translate and everything. I'd say the language barrier at first was the most difficult part, and second part was like Korean culture, I guess. You know, you have to know this, we call this riare, like being the, how do you say, the age
gap.
Age gap thing. Oops, excuse me, yeah, the age gap thing. So it was really hard for me to like learn the Korean formal speaking 존댓말, and also like informal speaking all these things and picking up their culture things. So. But it was fun. I mean, this whole process, I learned a lot, you know, like being a gentleman. I was a gentleman.
So recently and regretfully, we learned that you are no longer a part of the kid. Is it true that you're going away for studies, or is this a rumor?
I won't say it's a rumor, but I won't say that it's true. I mean, it's like, studies, I would say studying is something a need. I mean, it's something important. I mean, I'm gonna go back to studies one day, but not now. So, yeah. How should I say this? I'll be back to studies, but not now. I'm still. Someday. Still chasing after my dreams and everything.
So. Right. So, you know, I hate looking at the past, and I'm sure everybody hate looking at the past as well. But if I may ask, in 3 years that you were involved with UKIS, what is the most difficult part? Like, what is the moment that you knew that, you know, that's what you have to do? What sacrifices did you have to make?
I would say the most difficult part was the beginning, you know, I just came here for 6 months and I met all the members and everybody one by one. Beginning this thing and not even knowing Korean well, it was so difficult for me, you know. There were like so many misunderstandings through language, you know, like, and it was, cried, fought, and it was like, so nerve-wracking, but it's okay. I mean, I won't say it's really hard, but I would say the biggest sacrifice was my time. Because for 2 years, I mean, I was like a workaholic, actually working, hoping to bring the best to all my fans. And I would say I didn't have much freedom. And I couldn't even date anyone. No girlfriend, no nothing, and no personal life. But I won't say everything is hard. It was fun, actually, doing this whole process. I gained. I did not lose anything, so nothing really that hard. Yeah, the most valuable thing will be meeting my members, the six of them. Because we really, for this 3 to 4 years, we were like working together, grew up together, seeing each other grow, learning a lot from them, and learning to be a better person, to be a better, like, hyung, kind of elder brother from them. And, I mean, I just thank God for this opportunity and this whole brotherhood thing. It was a precious memory for me to go through everything with them until now. I love you guys. Thank you. I think the thing I regret the most would be I couldn't show the 100% of myself during this time being a UK's member. It's like, I don't know, it feels like, you know, the show, without a finale, the show was over, you know, lights on, go home, no, for me it was something like that, so I felt a little, you know, 아쉬워, we call this in Korean, like a little, oh, 아깝다. Oh my gosh, I forgot how to say this in English, like, this thing, like, oh, I didn't have this chance to show 100% of me, but it's okay, I mean, I'm still here, and I'm not dead, come on, I'm still here, so look forward for more of Alexander. 기대해주세요. My members, well, I settled everything to them, basically, especially during our last schedule in Indonesia, so now, like, in front of the camera, I would like to say one more time that all the best to your comeback, and just keep in touch. Don't forget to call me even though you're busy, or else I'm gonna smack you. So our fans, I would say thank you so much for like all these past 3 to 4 years. You guys have been supporting me, loving me, and teaching me a lot of different stuff. So it's sad that I couldn't go on being a UKIS member. I'm still here, and I'm gonna try my best to give you guys all the best I could. So stay tuned for everything, and look forward for all my plans and everything. Love you guys.